let's talk about S4DS promotion engine. In the last 30 years of experience working with the direct selling and retail industry, promotion control based on rules is the most stressful process in the company. So S4DS created a tool that integrates every single area of your company, marketing, sales, customer support, and logistics, so you can integrate all the different roles that every single area needs to push your business. It is a very easy to use, very integrated, scalable, very fast, and absolutely customizable and flexible for every single business. You can put this tool in every single of your processes, enrollment, sales management, marketing strategies, all your promotion life cycles, sales the planning, all the execution with all the real-time tracking, and finally with all the analysis at the end to understand all the performance in every single of your rooms. So what is the different features that you can find into the system? The first one is how to apply for every single stage of your business. When you need to incentivize the visits of your site, or maybe you need to activate more orders, enable more items into the order, or increase the purchase frequency, or increase the retention of your customers, and many others. The second one is how to apply those rules into maybe the push measures to the customer, or maybe to provide them a pricing benefit into the order, or maybe providing discounts, recommendations, creating dynamic bundles, or creating cross-selling screens and capabilities to provide more order options. During the transaction, controlling the shipping, payment methods, the number of points, you have a reward program, providing coupons, gifts, and many others. The administration of the system is incredibly simple. It's a one-click activation of every role, and you have wizards so your business areas can do with questions and answers, very simple business answers, create new rules. Behind that, there is a very strong technology piece that your technology area, your IT, can perform every single new role that you desire. The analytics is very important. We have the capability to integrate all this information that create a lot of data into a BI platform to understand all the behaviors, timing, decisions that are being made by the customer, so understanding our rules works or not. And finally, the integration of the system is absolutely simple. Using APIs, you can push the process into the rule engine and then call back all the responses of you control in your platform, whatever you want to do with every single of the rules. How S4DS promotion engine works? It is a very straightforward one. Your business strategy is being performed by your different areas. Okay, here we go. Now we have a clear path how to do it. Then you go to the second point, that is go to the centralized panel, just one click away to re-enable any rule that you used before. Three, maybe it's a new one, so you have a wizard, the business questions, nothing technical, that you can perform new rules very straightforward. Four, maybe you need something that you never did before, so you just call your IT department, the IT department log in into the platform, just do new set of rules and new set of parameters, can be very programmatic or could be very easy like an Excel program. And finally, the wizard came back again to you as a business area and you can do all the process. What is happening behind the scenes, there is a communication using APIs, very simple, pushing the appropriate information into S4DS promotion engine, the magic with all this process, and came back again with a result to you, so the appropriate outcome is performed in the platform. Provide the gift, provide the, the coupon, enable a new pricing option, or whatever you want to do. So it is absolutely great. Let's discuss this first step of this business promotion strategy and how to enable this into the platform. Maybe a first example is how to create and increase the visits of your site. So you are sending coupons that could be applied for certain products if you refer a new person into the company. Okay, that's require a rule because you need to understand if that person has been referred by you or not, and so on. So in this demo, what we're seeing is how to create the rule. Very straightforward. You just create a coupon that applies to a certain percentage of discount of the product if the SKU is certain SKU, plus the other condition is that it is being referred by another person, so in the next purchase you can earn this. As you're seeing, it is very straightforward to create the rule and how to see when you are creating the order if that applies or not. Let's go to another example, is how to increase the purchase activity. It is a very well-known strategy. So with all the historical data that you have in, I don't know, the kind of product that you're gonna buy, the amount of your normal purchase, your purchase frequency, or maybe with a goal that you need to achieve a certain moment, with certain geographical segmentations, or maybe with a complementary product that you want that customer to test, or maybe with the customer lifetime value, or because you're buying a certain moment, or because you want to communicate better with the customer. In any of those, you can create a rule, like in this example, in how to maybe in this quarter, with all the efforts that you do, if you complete at least 20 orders of your customer, this is for a seller, so great. So I will send you a push message, let you know that you will be, maybe in our invitation for a really nice event, maybe a premium concert that you're sharing or something like that. That's the kind of tools that you can do and the roles that you can perform into the system very straightforward. They dive in into another big business strategy, which is increment the number of units in an order. So there is a lot of different ways, cross-selling, free shipping, upselling, cross-selling, creating packages and dynamic combos during the order, temporary promotions, suggested or conditional products, redeemable products from a previous strategy point or something, bundles that you can customize. You buy this, you have the second one for free, or you have this other category, or maybe because you have your birthday or Christmas or any other given event, geographical location, or maybe depends on the number of items that you're adding into an order, and so on. There's a lot of ways to do it. In this small example, what we're doing is creating a package that has three items that you only pay two. The typical buy two, get three, so it is so great, but it's being conditioned by another rule that only enables you if you perform as expected. Another option is maybe to create a free shipping. That's another option that can be performed with the same set of rules. Let's see this interesting example. Now switching to how to increase the frequency of the orders. Okay. Normally, you can provide coupons, gifts, discounts, or maybe a strategy according to the payment method. That's try to trigger that your customer return to buy again because you have this special moment for them. In this small example, what we're doing is, depends on the payment method, we are triggering a discount, but could be triggered, to send you a coupon for a next order or any other given action. The idea here is how to provide the idea that you keep your momentum in the company. So maybe with a points-based catalog, with a reward program, or maybe with a repurchase activation, or maybe a goal-based bonus. If I do this during the next 3 months, something great will happen. In this small example, what we're doing is provided you an example of how to reward frequent purchases. If you buy this during this amount, during the month, you will receive something special. If you buy this number of items, could be another good great rule. So there is a lot of great holes around this topic. Now that we discuss all the different business strategy, let's discuss how to manage this in the platform. So the first thing is go to the centralized control, which is scope of the system, is how to take a look at every single strategy in your business timing, whatever it is, months or quarters or any other given process. And per process, you can activate every single rule just with a check. It is very nice to control what you do in your normal basis. In this example, we're activating and deactivating a few rules that will be required for this month, or maybe for the period that is opening next Monday, something like that. Adding a new capability into the previous point is to have a wizard that is a predefined strategy configurator to help you with only business questions, nothing technically, to go through every single new strategy that you want to create. Maybe you want to create any promotion rule or any other business strategy that requires several conditions, and this is the way to do it. In this example, we are providing you a couple ideas that can be performed. Maybe it's a coupon that I want to create that is based in several different aspects, how to be triggered, and how can be used. Another great example could be maybe a free shipping. Maybe it depends on the amount of the order, only for certain country or certain specific geographics, and so on. That's a set of rules that you usually predefined previously with another tool we will see later. Now is the moment to understand what is behind all this business process. So the checklist and the wizard is for the end users or the business areas, and the role engine and everything that's behind is for the more technical areas. So the first one is to understand how to set up your campaigns, your different timings in the company. Maybe it's monthly, maybe it's per quarter, maybe it's per week. So you can set up any timing that you want to handle. The second one is to understand your processes. Okay, I have a cross-selling process. I have a payment process. I have a item adding to the orders rules. So every single group of roles can be set up here. Then you can go and technically set up the wizard, all the business questions that will be behind your strategies. So that's the way the technical team ask to the business every single requirement to enable new strategies, like a whistle in the wizard. Then you can set up all the strategies, all of this setup per campaign. So it is a pre-setup that the business areas can use. Then you can set up all the strategies in terms of the roles. It's every single requirement of your roles, how to set up those. There's a very straightforward process to perform that. Could be in two ways, as we will see in the demo, more oriented in a schedule or something like that in Excel, or could be through a programming tool, which is Node.js. So in this demo, we will try to show you every single of these steps that I will already explain to you before. The first one is to see how you can set up your campaigns with the campaign manager. Then you can set up your different processes. Right here is a few examples. Then we can set up for every single strategy, different questions and data, how to map the data with your technical requirements. And then all these strategies, how it can be applied per period, like a pre-setup of the business area. And finally, the most interesting piece, which is the role engine functions, that you can set up all your different queries, questions, and technical analysis just to perform the roles in the two ways that I explained to you before, through the tree map with questions and answers, or to using Node.js as a deprogramming tool. It is so great. Let's discuss now how the technical architecture of the system works. So the first one is, could be either effortless modules or business modules, or could be your backend or your platform, whatever it is, that manage through the orders, when the order is being created, when the product is being added to the order, or when it's a promotion page to a cross-selling, or could be during the payment process, etc. So any of those, once again, in our platform, S4DS, or in your platform, whatever it is, in your corporate system or your backend. In any of those, the point is how to define the data that is required. So the first step is to create data sets, which is all the data that it will be required through events to be triggered, being calculated, and the next step with that data, create the API call. So when the API call is being triggered, the S4DS role engine will work behind the antennas. It will be per process, you grab the data set and run all the rules that are being set up previously, even though it has been programmed by the business or could be programmed by the technical team. Then the result came back with our middleware through events or through queues coming back to the main system that has been called. Once again, S4DS or your platform, whatever it is. And in that platform, what needs to be to happen is the outcome, which is the next step, will be produce the result that is required. But all the magic already happened in very short periods of time. It's incredible, it's scalable and fast. Then is the moment with the outcome of all these processes need to be produced. So all this process came to the middleware, which trigger, I don't know, your pricing, or to remove a shipping fee, or to add a reward in the order, or to block an order, or to block a registration process, or actually to activate or deactivate a user,
or maybe to generate a ticket that is required to process a certain workflow, or to grant a credit in order to enable an order, or to send a notification. So once again, the type of events is huge. It is extremely important that the rule engine can trigger that. So with that return in the data set is order, SKUs, pricing, etc., that has been calculated by the rule engine. So with that data in your process is just to enable the result. In the effortless examples, what usually happens is everything is real time. So in every single of these screens, we call the API, recalculate the data set, and came back the results a few milliseconds later with all the results. Hey, please enable these products, change these items, change this pricing, add this free gift, provide this extra coupon at the end, and so on. Just a few of the examples. As for the S promotion engine, enable the capability to work in your company in the different areas in a synchronous way. Marketing, sales, customer support, logistics have a unique tool to enable all the business roles that your business require in an appropriate way to attend your customers or your sales force. It is aligned to your business objectives, very easy to use. The integration capabilities are outstanding. The scalability, it is great. The performance and speed are extremely fast, and the customization and flexibility that you require is in there and can be applied to all your processes. Processes like your enrollment, your sales management process, your marketing strategies, your promotion lifecycle strategies, manage your catalog and commercial cycles, or your product portfolio, pricing, promotion, combos, etc., and all the order and inventory process. The different features that you can find in the tool really enable your business to do more than you're doing right now. The applicability of this model to all the business stages and all the processes. How to have in different UX options, communications, bonus, coupons, pricing, etc. It's extremely easy to manage, and the flexibility and the reporting enable you to understand if it is working or not. And finally, the API integrate this into your platform. The way that you can find this process properly is just to enable your strategies to increase the visits of your site, if the purchase orders, the activity, the number of units, frequency of your customers, retention, and many other business strategies can be enabled. How? Just using the promotional engine in the centralized control with a very simple checklist, or using the business wizard to enable very easy way to set up any new rule. The third part is to understand the rule engine that is behind the incidents and all these technical pieces that manage your campaign managers, your process, your wizards, and all the questions that you need, all the functions that you require per strategy and per campaign, how to toggle those in rules that you have two ways to manage through a very easy to use, like an Excel programming, or using Node.js if your technical team wants to do that. With all these tools, you can enable the architecture. So it's how to integrate your business processes, your platform, using the appropriate data, calling the APIs, doing all the magic in the process, coming back to the middleware, and finally produce the outcome that you are expecting. Just, I don't know, enable you a new pricing, a new coupon, a free shipping, or whatever you're expecting. So this is the appropriate way to manage your architecture. And nowadays, this is the business strategy that we require. So hope you enjoyed S4DS promotion engine.